Hello guys and gals, it's me, Mojo Daddy Mystic, and I'm back with another groovy review, and on this one, we are taking a look at Kiss's 1979 album, Dynasty, and their smash hit, I Was Made for Lovin' You. And this particular song comes in at a time where Kiss was on the verge of splitting up. They had been on the road for 10 years, going on 10 years, just about. And it began to take its toll, a lot of heavy drug use. Ace Frehley was dealing with alcohol problems and getting out of control. Him and Peter both. So it was kind of a messy time, and the band wanted to make a change, and you know, the times were changing. Disco was the new thing in music, and I guess they wanted to rekindle some of their previous magic on some of their albums. So they took a risk, as any artist would do, and they made their sound kind of fit with the times, and I think they should be applauded for this risk. A lot of the true blue Kiss fans hated this song, and it's understandable. It's not God of Thunder, or it's not a Strutton or Black Diamond, but hindsight, it's a good song. It's a song that that you can dance to and just have fun with. But initially, it was seen that Kiss was selling out, and I don't buy that. They were just taking a risk and, you know, throwing stuff to the board and see what sticks. But, you know, that's just my opinion. And on this song, it definitely shows Paul Stanley's vocal range, because he's going to hit some high notes that are insane, that no man should be able to reach. He definitely is reaching for the skies in terms of voices, and pretty good guitar work by Ace. And it's just a fun video. Music video too. So let's just see what you guys think of Kiss, I Was Made for Lovin' You. Let's vibe.
That drives me wild. And tonight,
yes, sir. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Oh, man. They're just having a good time. And then there's nothing wrong with that. Yeah, so I don't need to tell you what this song is about. I was made for loving you. You were made for loving me. I can't get enough of you, babe. Can you get enough of me? Pretty self-explanatory here as far as song meanings go. But did you guys see Ace Frehley's glowing guitar? That is 70s, late 70s rock in a nutshell. Just the exuberance and the, I'm trying to find the right word. The overindulgence of, you know, bands at the time. It's just extraordinary. Pretty cool. Pretty cool collector's item there, that glowing guitar. Man, that was sick. And big props to, again, Paul Stanley for his vocal range. And just a great, fun disco song. And the album Dynasty is not half bad. Like, it's got Dirty Livin', which is a great, great number. And I think Peter Criss doesn't play on this entire album except for Dirty Livin', or except for his vocal vocals on Dirty Livin'. He doesn't play drums on this entire album. And I think they've got a cover of a Rolling Stone song called 2000 Man. And also, what else is on that album? I don't know. But it's a good listen. So give it a listen sometime. Kiss Dynasty. This was the last of the original four before they did the lineup changes, and Peter Criss went on to have a solo career and all of that. And a quick shout out to my girlfriend, my angel. She's watching. I hope you can't get enough of me. All right. I was made for loving you. Did you like it? Did you not like it? Let me know in the comments below. This is Your Hippie with Harmony, Mojo Daddy Mystic, wishing you peace, love, and happiness. Till next time, rock on.